Every summer, the news brings us so many stories of shark attacks. But here's today's question: how likely are you to actually be attacked by a shark? According to diver Gary Atkinson, 90% or more of shark incidents are mistakes. They're assuming that humans are something humans are not, namely food. And some sharks are more aggressive than others. Great whites, tiger sharks, bull sharks, those are the top three of sharks likely to attack you for the following reasons. One, they're widespread. Two, they're large enough that human beings can look like prey. Three, they're super powerful and the first bite can cause fatal damage. Next, they're top of the food chain. This means they're not instinctively afraid of anything. Other shark species, of course, are not completely innocent. So if humans are not what sharks are looking for, what are they looking for? Let's think about it from the shark's point of view, okay? Many attack victims are surfers or people riding on boogie boards, what have you. A shark swimming below the water surface sees a roughly oval shape with arms and legs dangling off, paddling along, and this bears a close resemblance to a sea lion or a sea turtle, and those are some of sharks' favorite things to eat. Humans just are not on this menu. But how likely is it to happen to you? Let's play with some statistics. So there are between 30 and 50 unprovoked shark attacks reported worldwide each year. 5 to 10 of these are fatal. Florida has the most attacks in the United States. Since 1990, the numbers have ranged from 10 to 37 per year. And yes, the United States tops the list for attacks worldwide. The vast majority of these attacks occur within a few hundred yards of the shore, just because that's where most people enter the ocean. And yes, the number of attacks worldwide and in the United States has been increasing in recent years. It's not that sharks are becoming more aggressive, it's that people are taking coastal vacations and participating in more oceanic activities. When news stories and scientists do offer real statistics, they can easily be misleading. You've probably heard that you're more likely to be struck by lightning than to be attacked by a shark. So this statistic is based on the number of incidents each year. However, anyone can be struck by lightning when a storm comes through, right? Your chance of being attacked by a shark is zero if you live in Kansas and don't take a vacation to the coast. But if you surf every day off the coast of Florida, the odds of a shark attacking you are just going to be much higher. So the best tip is to be alert, always swim, dive, or surf with a buddy. Some of these attacks can't be prevented, but having somebody nearby to call for help can save your life. With all that being said, some fun statistics. In 1996, toilets injured an estimated 43,000 Americans. Sharks injured 13. You have a 1 in 63 chance of dying from the flu. Your chances of being killed by a shark? 1 in 3.7 million. Now let's compare that to your chance of dying from a fall. That's 1 in 218. We are more likely to die from a fall or a bad run-in with a toilet than we are to hit that horrible lottery of 1 in 3.7 million and be attacked by a shark. Add to that, there are several things you can do to make sure that you have a safe, fun summer. Always swim with a buddy. Don't be that one person out by themselves, way off from the coast, because, you know, that's a recipe for all sorts of trouble. So that's it. Thanks so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video. Please feel free to leave a comment with a suggestion or some feedback or another question. Feel free to like our video and subscribe if you want, if you're feeling charitable. I mean, we're pretty cool. We're not gonna send you junk mail or anything.